Put your hand together for the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you. May be seated. Our Father in the Lord, the pastor in charge of the province, the convener of this program, Pastor Alex Edosa, Igbinebeka, is unavoidably absent this morning. Went for a trip. And we are standing in place. And I trust God that with the support of our very senior fathers in the house, my daddy's the Lord increase and bless you more for us in the name of Jesus. That at their backing, the spirit of our Father and also the spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ in the house, God will do what he needs to do in the name of Jesus. All right, this morning, the topic is divine restoration. Divine restoration. The word divine means emanating from God. Something that is strictly from above. It has nothing to do with man. It is God. The word divine means something that emanates from God. And the word restoration means it is the act of restoring something or someone to a satisfactory state. Not just to restore something lost. If you were sick and you were also poor, and like Lazarus, maybe you died, and God restored you back to life, you may still not be happy because poverty is still worrying you. But when you are now restored to a state of satisfaction, then it is called divine restoration. Hallelujah. And we have different cases in the Bible where God restored different people. We had one leper that the Lord restored him. The Bible said, and Jesus said he should go and wash. And when he went and washed and returned, the Bible said his skin became like, also Naaman, like that of a newborn baby. Naaman's skin became like that of a newborn baby. That is divine restoration. Hallelujah. Our text this morning is Mark chapter 8, verse 22 to 26. Mark 8, 22 to 26. And he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him, and besought him, pleaded with him to touch the blind man. But instead of touching the blind man, Jesus took the blind man by the hand and did something unusual. He led him out of the town. Jesus. They brought the man that he should touch him, but he took him by the hand and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes, that's serious, Jesus then put his hands upon the man and asked him if he saw anything. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees, walking. After that, Jesus put his hands again upon his eyes and made him look up the second time. And he was restored. He was restored. You will be restored. Even if your life and your situation require more than one touch from God today, all the touches that you need, heaven will release for you, and you will be restored in the mighty name of Jesus. You know, sometimes when a child of God is struggling with problems, struggling with poverty, there are some mountains you struggle with, struggling with sin. I don't want to commit this sin anymore. The more you try, the more you fall. You repent, you fall back again. In the name of the Lord, it doesn't matter what chain has been holding you today. If your case requires 10 touch, 7 touch, heaven will touch you and restore you today in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says he was restored and he saw every man clearly, and then Jesus now sent him away to his house, saying, neither go into the town. That town where I took you from, do not return back there, nor tell it to any in the town. Glory be to God. Now, like this man, for anyone to experience and enjoy divine restoration, there are certain stages sometimes that God will need to take a man through. Oh, it's important to pray. It's important to pray. But the one of the things that prayer does is that prayer helps to align your life, helps to open your eyes to see certain things that you will need to do in order for you to receive certain things from God. So like this man, there are certain things or processes that God may need to take us through in order for us to, you know, enjoy restoration or encounter full restoration from God. Now note that all they requested when they brought this man was that Jesus should only touch this man. But you see, for God to restore any man, it is God that knows what the problem is in the life of that man. It is God that knows whether your own case, he doesn't even need to touch you. Because we have seen blind men come to Jesus and all he did was spoke a word through of us. Through of us. The man in John chapter 5 at the water, the pool of water. When Jesus came to him, he had been there for 38 years. Guess what? Jesus never touched him. The Bible said Jesus only said to him, "Rise up, take up your bed and walk." And the lame man rose up, took the bed and began to walk. Praise God. So God can heal a person, restore a person without touching you. But he knows what area are, you know, the problem in your life, and only God, because it is divine restoration. It is God that wants to do that restoration. So he alone knows what he needs to take you through. For this man, he needed more than a touch. For this man's restoration to happen, he needed more than just a touch. He needed more than just prayers. He needed more than just fasting. He needed more than just going to the mountain. He needed some other things. I don't know what you need for your sight and for your life to be fully restored. But whatever it is that your own case will need for full restoration today, before you leave here, God will make it happen in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Processes that brought about the restoration of this man. Number one, Jesus brought him out of the town. Jesus brought him out of the town. The Bible said they brought him that Jesus should do what? Should touch him. But Jesus laid hold on him and took him out of the town. I can imagine Jesus, very busy person, very busy. Well, he doesn't even have time for, but that man's case, you see, that's one thing I love about Jesus. Anyone that comes to God, the Bible said he will in no wise cast away. You left your home, you left your house, you use your money to buy data, and you are joining us on social media online. Listen to me. God honors the faith of men. He honors men that take their time to follow him. And so Jesus amidst his schedule took him by the hand and said, "Your case needs special attention," and took him out of the town. Why? Like this man, there are things that God may want to do in my life and in your life that he cannot do unless he first brings you out of where you are. He told Abraham, "For my dream to come to pass in your life, I need you to leave your father's house and your mother's house." I don't know where you are today. I don't know where life has put you. I don't know what situation, association, relationship, what job you got into, what business you got into that already trapped your life, and you are struggling since the day you entered that relationship. Today, God is bringing you out in the mighty name of Jesus. God is bringing you out in the mighty name of Jesus. He brought him out. He brought him out. Salvation brings you out from among your peers. This man needed, like Abraham, to be brought out. Why? Because sometimes what God needs to take you through, he can't do it in your life right where you are. There are certain things that God wants to achieve in your life this year. He can't achieve those things with the place where you are. He can't do it where you are. For restoration to take place, He needs to bring me and you out. Some of us, he needs to get us out of pride. Some of us, he needs to get us out of our wickedness. He needs to get us out of hypocrisy. He needs to bring you out. I don't know what it is that is tying you down. Maybe laziness, maybe fears, maybe anxiety, family problem, family bloodline. Today, God is bringing you out. If Jesus had not brought this man out, where his brothers and family were, he now spit on his eyes. Ah, that's serious. The Bible says Jesus, when he brought him out of the town, he spat on his eyes. Poor. I'm sure maybe his father would have slapped Jesus. Maybe their brothers would have carried their brother and said, what nonsense. Is it because we say we need prayer? You are not humiliating us. You are not insulting us. There are things that God wants to do in your life that he cannot do with certain people around you. There are relationships you need to sever. There are things you need to get out of your life. I hope God is speaking to somebody this morning, because a lot of times you may be the one hindering yourself. A sister got a job last year, and that job was her debt. He didn't know that that company is a company of cultists, so they employed her. From the day she resumed, she started growing lean. Growing lean. 1 month. There's nowhere they did not carry her to. Eventually, by the time they found out that this company, this is what used to happen to people that they employ, it was too late. She was already bones and she passed away. Sometimes there are places that God will need to bring you out. Some of you are in churches where God needs to bring you out before he can do certain things in your life. But I pray for you in the name of the Lord. I pray for you by the anointing of our Father, Pastor Alex Edosa Igbinemeka, by the anointing of our Father, Pastor E. Adeboye, every trap of the devil, everywhere they tied you, everything holding you down, that say you will not reach your goal, that say you will not know restoration, today you are coming out. Number two, Jesus spat on his eyes. Spat on his eyes. God has different ways of ministering to us. Different ways. All some need to behold is a touch. All some need is a word. For this man needed to be humiliated. I don't know, maybe something in his background needed to be settled. But God needed to humiliate him before he would restore him. Sometimes God takes you through challenges of life, takes you through mountains, takes you through some prison. Listen to me. There could never have been a palace for Joseph outside his prison. His palace was tied to his prison. That place that you call humiliation may be God's path to your restoration in life. So sometimes God may need to take you through some shaking. The Bible said, thou should you remember all the way which the Lord your God led you these 40 years to humble you and to prove you to know what is in your heart. And he suffered you to hunger these 40 years. The Bible said there was a shorter way, but God chose the longer way for them because he needed to take them through certain paths. I don't know what path God is taking you through in life. Some of you are fighting your prison. You are struggling with your prison. But Jesus didn't struggle with the man. The man didn't struggle with Jesus. Rather, he stood. He allowed Jesus to do whatever he wanted to do. He said, Lord, bring it on. Lord, I'm here for you. All I need is restoration. Take me through. Do I need to go and ask for mercy? Ask for forgiveness? Some of us, until you go and ask for forgiveness from somebody you offended, you won't see restoration. I watched a video by Dr. Benny Hinn. Some of you may have watched it. And he was talking about Kenneth Copeland went for a crusade somewhere. In that crusade, rather than the anointing of God come upon him and power, he became very sick. He became very ill. And he doesn't fall sick. So Kenneth Copeland said, Lord, what is happening? Why am I feeling like this? And God said to him, you spoke against my servant Benny Hinn. He said, Lord? He said, yes. And until you ask him for repentance, you will not be restored. Ah! He said, Lord, I'm sorry. He took the phone. He said, Benny Hinn, you are my friend. I'm your friend. I spoke against you. I spoke against you. Many of us are in the habit. We are taking it upon ourselves to drop men of God down, to speak against the anointed of God, to speak against men of God. Every time you do that, you throw a stumbling block in your way. Let God deal with you the way he wants. Listen to me. Today, he may give you a Jonathan. Tomorrow, he may decide to give you a Buhari. It doesn't matter. Whatever God brings, stand in the gap. Pray for your leader. Stop castigating your leader. Stop fighting your leader. It can serve as an obstacle to your restoration. Your mouth can become a snare. You are snared with the words of your mouth. And as soon as Kenneth Copeland apologized to Benny Hinn, he said strength came back. His anointing returned and the crusade was a success. Any area that you need to do restoration, any area that has tied you in life, that God need to take you through in order to prepare you, in order to rearrange you, I pray for you today, he will take you through. Number three, put his hand upon him. Let God put hand on you. Jesus, after he carried him out, took him out, spat on him, he now put hand on him. Said, the hand of God is upon me. Many of us, we push the hand of God. When God's hand is upon you, you say, leave me alone. Lord, I'm tired. I don't like this place you brought me. I don't like this thing you are doing to me. No, let him place his hand upon you. It's important. Number four, he asked him if he can see. Jesus said, what can you see now? Many of us used to lie. Even in church, we come to altar and lie testimony. You are still sick, but you want to help the pastor that is preaching. He said, praise the Lord. When pastor said, if you are sick in your body, come out. In my body, I was feeling pain. And that pain had been there for 3 years. When he said that, the thing left. Meanwhile, it's still paining you. But you are just trying. You don't need to fake it. This man didn't lie to Jesus. He said to him, I see men, I can see now. But what I am seeing human beings here, they look like trees. If you are not honest with God, you are not sincere in your walk with him, you can't experience total restoration. I've never seen a people like the church. We lie a lot in the church. We are called believers, but the truth is we don't believe. We are unbelieving believers. May the Lord restore me and you. May the Lord restore us to reality. Reality of life. You don't need to help God. You don't need to lie for God. Say it the way it is. Lord, I need help. Lord, I can see, but I can't see clearly. Lord, I know you saved me, but I still feel that I need help here. I am still feeling lost in my heart. When I look at women, something still rises up inside me. Help me, Lord. It is the one that call upon the name of the Lord that shall be saved. Stop lying about your condition. If you need help, ask for it. If you need help, stop trying to be nice with suit. Many of us are wearing suit and come to church. Landlord is waiting. You are about to die. Child of God, pour yourself. Pour yourself before the Lord. And then, finally, Jesus made him to look up. Made him to look up. Why? That's where your help comes from. Even in opening yourself, be careful not to tell everybody your problem. You don't know who will mock you, who will shame you. And then after that, so look up, look up, look up to God. This morning, you are here to look up to God. Finally, he sent him to his house. Child of God, there is a house for you. God made a house for Adam. He took man and put him in the garden where he made for him. There is a place for you. Child of God, in this year 2020, there is a place for you. There is a place of hope for you. There is a place of joy for you. I thought I'm talking to somebody this morning. There is a place of joy for you. There is a place of rest in your marriage. There is a place for you in marriage. Are you 49 years? And you are, no man has ever saluted you. Get ready. He sent him to his house. God is sending you to your house today. Your house of joy. Your house of marriage. Your house of abundance. Your house of healing. You're out of that hospital. You are leaving the hospital. You are returning back to your house. There is a house for you. There is a house for you. Where there is money, where there is anointing, there is a place. He will push you to your place. I don't care who likes you, who doesn't like you. That place, the that God prepared for you. He's pushing you there. You are entering there. If I'm talking to somebody this morning, jump up on your feet. Lift your two hands to heaven and begin to bless the name of the Lord. Thank Him, because it's your time of restoration. Today's your day. Today's your day. Today's my day. Hour of restoration. Lord, restore me. Restore me, oh God. Don't leave me like this. Jesus, don't leave me like this. Take hold of me. Lay hold on me. Lay hold on me. Lay hold on me. Rakopataya. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.